Hey, horse people. Wanted to do a quick one on this. This is, since I'll post this video, it's going to be up for a while, people. ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease, I guess. They did a challenge, the ice bucket challenge, to challenge friends to raise money for this disease. And I'm trying to get this thing straight. Anyway, so they're challenging everybody to pour ice water on them, and then you challenge someone else, and that person is supposed to either donate or pour ice water. So this is what's kind of going on at this time. I mean, a year from now, when somebody watches this, it may be people forgot about it, so that's why I'm explaining why she's dumping ice water on her. So basically, you challenge somebody to dump ice water on them, and then they take the challenge, they challenge someone else. So this lady decided to do it on her horse. And the horse gives a pretty good response, and it gives a predictable response. Of course, some people are going to say horses aren't predictable and that this isn't a predictable response. I say it is. So, I'm going to go through here. We'll let it run through one time, and then I'm going to freeze frame as we go on through here. So, she's sitting up there. Horse is calm and relaxed. Horse's tail is calm. He's listening to her talk, looking at her moves. She's got a bucket, may hear it. Okay, so then she grabs her top, loses her balance, and it slides right off his head. I think that's pretty good. So anyway, we're going to throw one more time real quick. And then I'm going to go through a freeze frame. So, on how quick the horse figures out something's wrong. And, you know, the horse really didn't buck or throw her off. He kind of stopped and bent his head. Was like, and finally, you know, why are you sliding up? Because she was wet, she slid up around his neck. So it kind of caused him to stop on his front end. So let's start this over here so I can stop it right when she picks up the water bucket. So I'm going to stop it here. Let's look at the horse. The horse's ears are behind. He's paying attention to her. They're not pinned. Tail's relaxed. Back legs are relaxed. Standing in a comfortable position. So we're going to start it. Shook there a little bit, maybe cut a little fly. You saw a little flake there. Zoom in a little bit there. Okay, she picks the water bucket up. You notice his ears went back just a little bit more. His feet are still the same. Get down to his feet. His feet are still the same. Ears are back. Still the same, the water's coming down. It hasn't hit the horse yet. Feet are still the same. Head's still kind of a level, flat line, relaxed stance. He knows something's going on. The ears are back paying attention to her. What's she doing? She's shifting her weight. She's picking up a bucket. Maybe she doesn't ride a bucket. So the horse kind of knows what's up, but he's not really reacting just yet. Okay, immediately when that water hits that horse, head goes up higher. Back leg goes into fight or flight. He gets that immediate kind of, oh crap, I gotta run. You see him start to shrink up. The body starts to curl a little bit. He gets collection to either jump, rear, fight, flight. He doesn't know what happened. He just knows he got a really big shock of water right now. Plus, she probably tightened her legs and I think I hear her kind of scream or make a little noise. That concerned the horse. Again, the horse isn't being bad or mean here. He's being totally reactive. Okay, immediately he shoots forward. He uses his power to go forward. Throws her off center gravity. Her legs come forward. She's off center gravity, sliding backwards. She reaches for the reins. Horse's head's high. Got that forward momentum. Look how much he shrunk. Look how much his body collected in and just really powered up to like, I got to get out of here. So he went into flight mode pretty quick there. And it didn't take long when that cold water hit him and splashed him. He didn't know what was going to happen. He didn't take the challenge. Guinea's shooting off. She kind of regains her balance. I don't know if she grabs the reins or his mane there. Obviously, she's screaming. His slant, all his power's going to his rear for pushing off. He's really lunging and taking off forward. He's getting a lot of speed. So the fact that she stayed on was pretty good. Okay, she drops the bucket here, which kind of probably helped him relax a little bit. So the bucket hits the ground. She kind of gets her seat. She's not leaning back. Here the horse kind of settled out a little bit. kind of leveled out, head's kind of going down, like, okay, I'm not that bad. She's settling down, looks like she got her movement there. Worried about her top there, reached one hand, that threw her balance off, that dropped her shoulder, that may have made her slide a little bit. Her legs kind of opened up there as she slid back a little bit. Again, the horse is getting forward momentum here. Looks like she's going to be okay. Looks like things are going to work out okay. The horse is just going to kind of take off and run off. Throws that little buck right there. Just that little bit. Got her off center of gravity. Threw her weight forward. I always tell people, when you're on a bucking horse, you want to be laying down flat. Get that back on that horse's back. If you watch professional buck riders, they're always laying down flat on their back, because you don't want your forward center of gravity getting above those shoulders on that horse. And right here you can see her center of gravity is gone. She's going forward. And the horse kind of realized this. His head's going down, so he's going to stop pretty quick. He kind of goes down. She's already in the air, kind of going over. Of course, the tail's active. His head drops. And he stops pretty quick. She's way out of balance. Still has the reins sliding over his head. And I'm pretty sure she's probably going to hit the ground here in a second. Just a guess. Going straight over, he stops, sees her in front. Right here, she's flying through the air. She's probably thinking, that probably wasn't the best idea I've ever had. Maybe I shouldn't have poured that water on my horse and shocked him, but it's too late for afterthought at this point. So she's going to find out the hardest thing about riding is the ground. She hits the ground, and the camera lady laughs. And I laugh. One more time, really quick, see if you can pick up those things as they happen in really quick action here. Water hits a horse, curls up, bucks, takes off, runs, bucks, throws her off, she hits the ground, stops. Very quick. So, anyway, just kind of looking at the fundamentals on reading, had she been paying attention, her hands were up, she was holding a bucket, she doesn't have a saddle, she doesn't have stirrups, the horse really got shocked and kind of went into a spook or flight mode, and because her hands were up in the air and she wasn't ready, she wasn't hanging on, she didn't have her center of gravity, she couldn't control it. Had somebody else poured that water and she would have been ready to ride, she probably would have rode that out, because the horse really didn't go into a bucking fit. It was more of a, hey, you're sliding around, you're off center of gravity, you kind of scared me, I kind of bucked, what's going on? After he ran a few steps, he's like, okay, I'm not trapped, okay, the cold water went away, maybe I'm not in danger. He kind of got his head and kind of stopped a little bit, but by that time, she was over his head, flying off and falling. So again, because it happened so quick, really like right when she lifts this bucket, the change in this horse. I mean, you can just see his ears and everything right there. He's kind of like, what's going on? Why is that going on? Watch how quick. See, the water's only about right here. Now the water just hit him. Watch how long it takes for this water and that head to start going up. Pretty much immediately. So, I mean, you know, they say the only thing faster than a horse kick is another horse reflex. Horses don't get kicked as much because their reflexes are as good as a horse's kick. And, so anyway, I just wanted to get that out there. Kind of a interesting little video on the horse's response to this. I thought he did great. He's a good horse, and obviously this kind of shocked him, and she spent some time with him, and I'm not saying this is really mean to the horse, or she's hurting a horse, or this is cruel. I'm not getting into all that. Don't be hating on her. But it was kind of interesting to watch the horse kind of show his language on when I'm shocked and I go into that flight mode. All right, we'll end it there. Hope that helps. Buddy, Miss T, you're good boys.